So in order to do this, you'll need hair a few inches longer than shoulder length. If your hair isn't long enough, you can either add extensions or use a wig, as I'm using here. The first thing you'll need to do is separate your hair equally on either side of your head. So then just tie off the side you're not using to keep it out of your way. So on the side that you're working on, you're just going to divide that into two sections, with the front section being about half as much as the back section. Then you're just going to want to comb that out, get rid of any tangles, make sure everything's all good and smooth. And then you'll take a piece of fabric about 7 inches long, and you're just going to wind the bottom of that small section of hair around it. And then you're just going to proceed to roll that all the way up that section of hair, making sure you keep it good and tight. You just want to roll that up as high as you can get it to go. Then twist it. Tighten up the ends of the fabric. Put a safety pin through them to hold the ends together. And then you'll just shimmy the hair around what is now a circle of fabric. And then you're just going to put in several bobby pins to hold that in place. You're going to want to bobby pin the actual bun to the hair, and then you're just going to bobby pin the pieces of hair in place so they stay where you want them to stay. And if it's a wig, you can bobby pin it to the actual fabric part of the wig. And so once you've got that bobby pin in place, you'll just comb out that back section, again making sure that everything's smooth and untangled. And then you're just going to take another strip of fabric. This time you want it almost as long as the hair, about 4 inches shorter. You're just going to stick that on the back side of the hair, make sure that the hair goes all around it, and then you're going to twist it to make sure that the piece of fabric is entirely covered. You want it totally concealed by the hair, and this will just give it a little bit of extra width to make the bun thick. You want to make sure you hold it tight as you're twisting it, and then you'll wind it up around the smaller bun. And you'll have to keep kind of twisting and holding and winding all at the same time. But you wind that all the way around, keep twisting the bottom, and then you'll just kind of bury the ends in the back of the bun. And then you'll want to take a lot of bobby pins and pin everything all in place. You want to hold the coils together with the bobby pins, as well as hold them to the rest of the hair. And my wig did have bangs, so I'm just going to tuck those under the buns when I wear the wig. And if you see any bobby pins, you can just run a little bit of hair over them to hide them. And so then, of course, you'll just do the same thing to the other side. And so then here is what the completed wig looks like from both sides. And I actually did not use enough bobby pins on this. You're going to want to use even more bobby pins than I did, because as you can see, it's actually falling off the one side of my hair.